today or wherever, dear Lord, let your fire destroy them.
Amen.
We cover our gathering, God of Jesus.
Lord of Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank God for every one of our lives. I also want you to know that it's a time to just put your phone in silence if you can. And we'll all please keep our mask on, and it should be on throughout. As God leads us today, we'll be talking on heavenly intervention. Heavenly intervention. When heaven intervenes, in most cases, it uses an earthly process. Amen.
Amen.
But many, we don't understand. We just believe in a particular way. And so when God is using the other way, we are not able to identify the intervention of heaven in our lives. And I'm trusting God that as you hear God's word today, God will open your eyes and He would remove those scales away from the eyes.
Amen.
Heavenly intervention, God uses earthly process to intervene. There are times the Lord in His sovereignty intervenes.
Yes.
And that could be sudden. It could be sudden. That miracle comes in the twinkle of an eye. It is God that has that power alone. But even when God does this, it is also in agreement with man. Maybe God bringing the dead back to life. He uses a man. When the living God was in the flesh, he used that man, Jesus. And He used some holy prophets in the world. So even then, when God intervenes in His own sovereignty to bring a sudden intervention, He also collaborates with men. So even an earthly process is also there. An earthly involvement. Amen.
Amen.
Because many of us, when men are favoring us or we are receiving help, we don't ascribe that to heavenly intervention. It looks like as if maybe it's your watch or your luck. But even that is how God intervenes. See, the story of the creation of the earth and the process that it took has led many of us into misconception. The story of Genesis, how God created the earth in 6 days, and it happened suddenly, it has led many of us to misconception, and we now believe that is the only way God intervenes. Because God said, let there be light, and there was light. And God says, you will be rich, and you are rich. Just like that. Immediately. And when these things do not happen that way, it looks like as if heaven has not intervened. Our expectations of heavenly intervention sometimes and in most cases could be wrong. Our expectations of heavenly intervention in most cases sometimes they are wrong. So we should understand the way God has created this earth and the laws He has placed here. That is the way things will happen here. The word of God and the revelation of God is like a dream. The word of God and the intervention of God is like a dream. It's like tongues, which needs intervention, interpretation. The word of God is like a dream. I want you to know this today, believers. Even when it looks so literary, when it looks so, the English is so clear, it still needs interpretation. But not the interpretation of the spirit of man, but the spirit of God. So the word of God is like a dream. It's like tongues. It needs interpretation. So whatever God tells you, whatever you read in God's word, even when it looks very plain and clear, it still needs heavenly interpretation. Amen.
Amen.
In the book of Ezekiel, in where we read in the scriptural reading, in chapter 37 from verse 1 to 10, God took Ezekiel in the spirit to a valley. This valley was full of dry bones. These were not bones that are fresh. It means the people that owns those bones, they have long died long time ago. They have died long time ago. The bones were not dry. God knows how many years or centuries that they were dead. And God took this man of God to see these bones. It was full of bones. And God made the man of God to behold it. That was an impossible situation. That was a situation that was gone beyond control. It was gone beyond redemption. And God told the man of God, he asked him, can these bones live? And the man of God was startled. God is asking you today, that thing that looks impossible in your life, God is asking you, can it be revived? There are things we have already discounted. And no need to pray that prayer again. Maybe because of age, maybe because of circumstances, because of location, because even that which will make it happen is not available. And sometimes we take our mind off it. Let me tell you, in the Lord, nothing is impossible.
Amen.
So God took the man of God to that valley and he said, can these bones live? God is asking you, can those bones in your life, can they live again? Those impossible situations. Man will present you with impossible situations. Could be hurt, could be wet, could be relationship, could be something you really desire in your heart and you have stopped believing. Because man have given you all the data that prove to you that it is not possible for you to have it. You can see it. X-rays, documentation, scan, test. It proves that you cannot have it. You are not one of those that can have it. In the Lord, nothing we cannot have. He took him to this valley and God now laid the plan to him. He said, Ezekiel, you are to prophesy on these bones. You have to make a declaration. And then, listen now. It will take a process. It will take a process. God gave him the different processes. It will take stages. If God says you become a billionaire, it's going to take stages. It's going to take process. And because of that, it's going to take time. It's not something that will happen immediately. Even when God took Ezekiel there, Ezekiel did not say, bones live, and they all stood up and lived. No, it took process. It took stages. But why it was taking this process and stages in an earthly manner, it was heaven indeed that was intervening. You see a seed going to the earth. It spends some time there and it shoots as its ear. It becomes a little plant. A day it becomes a big plant and one day it brings us fruits. And it looks like it's man, But that is heavenly intervention. That is the way God says things will happen on this earth. That is the way God intervenes on this earth. So when God says something, we are to agree with it by true prophecy, true declaration, true agreement. And then we will walk. There must be human collaboration with heaven. When God even intervenes suddenly in his own power, maybe by bringing the dead back to life, he also needs a man or a woman to agree with heaven, to pray over that child, to pray over that situation. So God will still use an earthly process. Amen.
Amen.
But all these are within God's prerogative and power. All these are God's power manifesting. Amen.
Amen.
When we look at the book of Isaiah, chapter 45, verse 12 to 13. Please someone help me. The book of Isaiah, chapter 45. 12 to 13, thank you.
I have made the earth and created man upon it. I, even in my hands, have stretched out the heavens, and all their host have I commanded. I have raised him up in righteousness, and I will direct all his ways. He shall build my city, and he shall let go my captives. Not for price, nor reward, saith the Lord of hosts.
Amen. Amen. So the word of God says, he has put man here, that through man, heaven will intervene on this earth. They are not angels that will bring your miracles on this earth. God will use a man like you to bring your miracles. When you apply for something and you find favor and it's given to you, it is not that man, it's not your qualification, it is heaven intervening in your life.
Amen.
Actually, you just received a miracle.
Amen.
You just received a miracle. When you are pregnant in labor and you go into the hospital labor room, and you deliver safe, and your child is safe. It is not man, it is just heaven that has intervened.
Hallelujah.
In fact, you just received a miracle.
Amen.
That is how God has ordained that heaven will happen on this earth. Everything will take a process, and it will need the collaboration of man. If we do not understand this earthly process as the heavenly intervention, then we will not give glory to where it is due. Many of us, we have not given the right glory to God because we are not able to interpret, we are not able to design the heavenly intervention in that process. Because it looks so earthly. It looks so earthly. Everything happened like that, and sometimes we think it was our beauty, our qualification, our whatever, our finance that helped us. If you have everything on this earth and you don't have God, you can lose everything on this earth. I tell you that. If you have everything and you don't have God, well, you can, in fact, there are many millionaires that have died from this virus. They had everything, but they didn't have God. And their possession could not give them the one thing they needed. Amen.
Amen.
And they lost it all. So God has ordained it to be so that every heavenly intervention, most cases, they will happen through an earthly process. The word of God concerning that child, it will happen through an earthly process. But Genesis said, God said, let there be light. And there was light. God says you have a child and you want to have it immediately. And when it doesn't happen immediately, your doubting mind stands up and start doubting God. God says you shall prosper. And you entered here the first 6 months, 1 year, maybe some few years. Nothing has happened. We start doubting. We do not know. It will take an earthly process. Maybe the person God will use, the company God will use, the government God will use, they have not been elected yet. Maybe the government that will bring a new law that will not make you flourish and blossom, that government has not been elected yet. One government needs to be removed first, and that government will come in, and all of a sudden, they will bring in a law that will make the word of God fulfilled in your life. So we must understand that earthly process of it. And we must be able to identify it so that we will be able to give honor and glory to whom it is due. Amen. Or else you will end up, I see people, it's good, you will also thank man that God has used to help you. Go give drinks, gifts, go give things to that man. But above all, know God to thank. Know that it is God that has touched our heart. See, if God has not touched a heart, even your husband will not bless you. It will look like as if your husband is wicked to you. Your own husband. Your own child. You'll be wondering, what have I done? And sometimes we'll be giving it to witches and wizards. The heart of every man is in the palm of God. If a man's heart turned to favor you, God give glory to God. Because it is an heavenly intervention. Actually, it is a miracle. It is a miracle. But we see when the dead come back to life, we say miracle has happened. But I tell you, almost every day, miracles follow you. Because heaven is intervening every time. Every time. And it looks like as if you are favored or lucky. There's nothing like that. It is God that has intervened in your life. Amen. In the book of Exodus chapter 23, verse 27 to 30. Exodus chapter 3, 23, sorry. 27 to 30. Thank you.
I will send my fear before thee, and will destroy all the people to whom thou shalt come. And I will make all thine enemies turn their backs unto thee. And I will send hornets before thee, which shall drive out the Hivites, the Canaanites, and the Hittites from before thee. I will not drive them out from before thee in 1 year, lest the land become desolate, and the beast of the field multiply against thee. 30. By little and little I will drive them out from before thee, until thou be increased and inherit the land.
Amen. Amen. Now God made a solemn promise to Abraham, the father of the faithfuls. He said, he will possess the land of Canaan, a land flowing with milk and honey. A land of promise. God promised it to Abraham. In the fulfillment, God says it's going to be by a process, little by little. The Father, God has promised Abraham, that was God's word. God has promised an heavenly intervention in Abraham's offsprings, possessing the promised land. But the word of God says it's going to be little by little. Actually, you know how it happened? They had to fight it out. They had to fight in Jericho. But God made them to win. They had to fight against the Hivites. God made them to win. They have to fight against the Jebusites. But God made them to win. They have to fight against all the Hivites that were in that land. But God made every time Israel to win. But the people have to fight it out. It has to take an earthly process. Even though God has promised it. But the miracle was that anytime they fight, they will win. Whether they have the best weapon, whether they are more in numbers, whether there is sun, whether there is rain, in whatever terrain, Israel will win. They didn't just walk in there, close their eyes, and all their enemies will just fall. They will just come, all their enemies, they are all dead. There were instances also happen like that. But they have to tighten their belts and agree with heaven. They have to. Even when the walls of Jericho came down, flat down, they have to surround it about and walk about for 7 days. But while they were fighting their enemies, Gideon won 100,000 Midianites or Syrians, I can't remember, with 300 people. And you say, what is that? That was an heavenly intervention. But it took an earthly process. But the miracle was that, even though they were so few, they won the battle. So, it was not the expertise of Gideon, neither the Israelites, but God's sovereign intervention. But why did God do it that way? Why did God have to do it that way? Why do God need man for it to happen? Why does God need you for his miracle in your life to happen? We must understand this. Why God does these things. In Psalm 115, verse 14 to 16. Someone please help me. Psalm 115, 14 to 16. Thank you.
The Lord shall increase you more and more, you and your children. Ye are blessed of the Lord, which made heaven and earth. The heaven, even the heavens, are the Lord's. But the heads are still given to the children of man.
So God dwells in heaven. The heaven of the heavens are the Lord's. But the earth, he gave to the Son of Man. God will not violate his own word. This act, he gets to the Son of Man. But because he is God, he also uses the Son of Man to bring to manifestation his heavenly intervention. You go out and someone help you. Someone forgives you. People have not taken you by what you have said or done. I tell you, all these are miracles. All these are miracles. We make errors. And God make us not to die because of that error. Instead, a second chance is given to us by our fellow men. That is a miracle. That is a miracle. In fact, everything that God does on this earth, they follow an earthly process. That is how God has planned it to be. Because the earth he has given to the sons of men. Because God uses the Son of Man for you. He also uses you for others. See, God is the revealer of secrets. He's the interpreter of hidden things. When we read the Word of God, the Word of God comes to us. We must ask God for discernment. How? Mary asked Angel Gabriel. Angel Gabriel said, you are going to have a child. And Mary said, I have not met a man. Mary had to ask the Angel Gabriel. Gabriel, how will it happen? Give me the process. How is it going to happen? Because Mary knew that it's going to follow an earthly process. But man will be taken out of the equation. How is it going to happen? Am I going to sleep with a man? How will it happen? And then Gabriel have to interpret it to her. That the Holy Ghost shall come into you. And then the earthly process will start. That child will become a fetus in the womb. That child will start growing legs and hands. That child will be born. It will be very feeble and vulnerable. That child will grow and play with other children in the sand. That child will acquire strength. A day will come. That child will be 30 years. And then the word of God that is said in the Garden of Eden will be fulfilled.
Hallelujah.
Also, through a man. The word of God says, the man Jesus. In some places, it did not say the Lord Jesus. It said the man Jesus. When God was delivering mankind, he did not bring angels. He brought a man. And he had to go through the earthly process. But indeed, when Jesus was being arrested, when his body was being destroyed, it was a miracle, but an earthly process. That is how it took. I want you to reflect this on your life, on God's promises concerning your life. And your mind is telling you, you will just wake up and in the morning, your bank account is overflowing with pound sterlings. It will not happen that way, even if God says it, even when the angel comes to print it in your head, it will not happen that way. God will use the earthly process. And that will make him win a lotto, which is an earthly process. But you have to play it, which is also an earthly process. Or you make you work hard and they start paying you good pay. Or you make you get a contract. You make you find favor. All these are earthly process. But indeed, it is not you. Indeed, it is not men. Indeed, it's not circumstance. It is God fulfilling his word.
Amen,
amen somebody.
Amen.
That should never leave our mind. That what is happening to me right now, I know this is God intervening. When you wake up and your husband still loves you, say, God, I thank you.
Amen.
This is a miracle.
Yes.
When you live among neighbors that love you, I want you to say, God, I thank you, for this is a miracle.
Hallelujah.
See, no man owe you anything. Don't become someone that will be expecting from others. No man owe you no nothing. No man owe no man no nothing. If man gives to you, it is because your Father in heaven has made him to give to you. Our children don't even owe us anything. God only uses us to bring them to this earth. So when the child that you get back to come back and say, thank you, mom, my mom. Thank you, my dad. Have this, my dad. And he shows love to you. Go and thank God, for that is a miracle. There are some children you give birth to, you never see them again. You will grow them up, not that they were adopted. So, no man, oh, no man, no nothing. If any man shows favor to you, it is your Father in heaven, indeed, that is showing favor to you. So what has not yet come to pass, according to God's word for you, I want you to look out. For when men change their attitude towards you, when someone calls you in the morning and give you something, I want you to know it is the beginning of heavenly intervention.
Amen.
God has started. When God makes one of your children where there's no hope, God opened a door for them. I want you to know, it's the beginning of the breakthrough. For one child will pull the other. And then will pull the other. And one that will pull the other. And then will come. Everything is green and rosy. You'll be brought into the promised land. You'll be brought into greener pastures. God has finally answered you. What he said 50 years ago, he has finally answered you. But it took an early process. It took pains. It took tears. It took time. When we are in pains, when we are in tears, when we are suffering, to achieve that thing, we think it is us. There are many that shed tears. They will shed blood. They will suffer. And yet, they were not fulfilled. So if your own was fulfilled, it is because that is a miracle. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
In the book of 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 5. Let's have this in our mind, for when we do not understand this earthly process that God uses as his own heavenly intervention, we will never be able to give glory to God. We will never be able, because we will not be able to interpret it. Many believers today, they are expecting a miracle. Even when they are inside the miracle. Amen.
Amen.
Many believers today, they are expecting a miracle. Even when they are inside the miracle. They do not understand. Many believers are in manifold miracles. Manifold. Every day is a day of miracle. I tell you, in the morning you see someone smile to you. At midday, someone give you a hand. In the early afternoon, you see someone giving you a gift. In the evening, somebody say welcome. I tell you, all these are miracles. All these are miracles. Go and listen to that other man's story. Go and listen to that other woman's story. You will know that your own is a miracle. Your own is a miracle. Heaven is intervening. But it uses an earthly process. Do not forget the Creator. The Creator of the earth. The Creator of that process. The Creator of that man. Is this God that you put your trust on? God also intervened with his own sovereign power to bring immediate healing, or bringing the dead back to life, or making something to happen immediately. God made fire to descend from heaven on Mount Carmel. But God also used Elijah. He also used a man. There is no place God has intervened except in creation, where God has intervened on this earth without man. After creation, God put a kind of world around the earth that anything that will happen on this earth, henceforth, it must be in collaboration with man. When he had to deliver mankind, and he found no man righteous enough, worthy enough, rather than sent angels that have no sin. He sent a man with the Spirit of God. But he had to be a man. He had to be a man. Because nothing on this earth will happen without a man. So he came in the nature of man, called Jesus Christ. That man right now, he sitting at the right hand side of the Father, and he continues to intervene for you.
Amen.
He continues to intervene for me.
Amen.
That man is tireless.
Amen.
That man lives for eternity.
Hallelujah.
That man will come back again, and he will come to pick his fellow men that put their trust in God.
Yeah.
It is that man that God used to deliver his fellow men. He is the one that will come again. Because he's a man. He has the power. He has the right to enter this earth. Because he's a man. And he will come and separate his children from the children of Belial. Amen.
Amen.
1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 5, please.
For there is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus.
Say, there is one God. There is one mediator between God and man. It did not say the Lord Jesus. The word of God says, the man Jesus. The man Jesus. That is whom God used to deliver all mankind. The man Jesus Christ. The man Christ Jesus. It has to follow the earthly process. But while Jesus was doing that, it was an heavenly intervention. Whatever God is going to do for you, do not take it. You went and you followed therapy. You followed those intervention, maybe surgery, maybe you follow medicine, and indeed God bless you with your child. I tell you, that's a miracle. It has nothing to do with those men. Countless people have done that before, and it did not happen. In fact, people have done double of that. People do surrogacy. They do different things now. Transplanting, whatever. And some people have done it, God knows, 20 times. And some people, even before they even do it, they have twins. And they say, that hospital, I recommend you go to that hospital. Someone else will go. If God says yes, nobody can say no. If God say no, I tell you, no man, no demon can say yes. It is heavenly intervention, but the carnality of the heart of man has made man to start thinking that because there is nothing sudden, because it did not happen immediately, because it did not come the way he expect, then it can't be God. All is God. Amen.
Amen.
And unto him should be all glory.
Amen.
We'll end with the book of Romans chapter 5 verse 15. I want us, our brethren in Novara, I want you to know that even now, heaven is intervening on your behalf.
Amen.
I want you to receive it.
Amen.
Heaven is intervening on your behalf.
Amen.
Do not despair. Do not question. Just trust. The heart of every man is in the palm of God. No man can kick against the pricks. That is what God told Saul that became Paul. A man cannot kick against his stone, his soul, neither his spirit. For when he sleeps, his spirit subjects himself to the Holy Ghost. And whatever the Holy Ghost instructs the spirit, the man will wake up and he will see himself doing it. Do not despair. Put the heart of every man in the hand of God. Even Satan works indirectly for the glory of God. Satan said, let us crucify him. He's another prophet. But he didn't know that he was playing into the hand of God. Said, Jesus has to die to destroy death. Jesus has to die to destroy Satan. But who killed him? Satan. Thinking, I've captured another one. But this time, he He didn't know that Jesus had to die to destroy Satan. I tell you, Jesus will bring Satan down like a lightning.
Amen.
That prayer we prayed earlier, it was not just because we want to pray it. It was also a revelation. God revealed to a man and a woman. They were above the earth, like as if they were in space. And they were accusing someone. I do not know for no reason they fell. The two of them, they fell. They were just coming to the earth with head. And they were coming swiftly. And they fell into the ocean. God is my witness. They fell deeply into the ocean and they got crushed. And that one that they were accusing, that one was enthroned.
Amen.
Even until this morning. So we pray that prayer that every Satan, every accuser, every agent of the devil in the spirit of physical realm standing in an exalted place against you, they shall crush.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
For Jesus said, I behead Satan crashing into the earth like lightning. So it shall be in every one of our lives.
Amen.
Romans 5:15. Thank you.
But not as the offense, so is the free gift. For if through the offense of one many be dead, much more the grace of God and the gift by grace, which is by one man, Jesus Christ, hath abounded unto many.
Amen.
So we see this scenario. Man was in an eternal condemnation. There was no way again man would ever live with God. Satan was very happy and satisfied. He has finally sabotaged the will of God. But God had a plan. God had a strategy. Satan knows that angels cannot come to this earth. Satan knows that God the Father will not come down to this earth. The heaven is the throne of God. So when man was driven away from the presence of God, Satan felt the game is ended. But God had a strategy. I declare that every Satan in your life that is rejoicing that they have won the battle, the Lord in your life shall release a strategy. He shall release a strategy that will be wise and destroy the game plan of Satan.
Amen.
Every impossibility, every impossible thing, the Lord will devise a way and it shall break every yoke.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Satan didn't know that God would come in man. Man is already polluted. Man is already destroyed. But God has a strategy. No man can come to this earth after Adam and Eve without Adam and Eve sleeping together. And Satan said, any man that comes through Adam is already finished. But Satan did not know that the creator, the master planner, the chief strategist,
hallelujah,
he has yet more strategies in his bag. The Satan in your life do not know what God is about to do. I tell you, Satan, just wait and you will soon behold.
Amen.
Satan must fall like lightning against any of us.
Amen.
Every Satan in that exalted place, they must crash like lightning.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God devised a plan. And that plan came through a man. God used the earthly process to bring about heavenly intervention. Whatever whatever you receive from your fellow man, freely. I want to know it's heaven's intervention.
Yeah.
It's not because you are too good. There are many things we do not merit that we are having right now.
Yes.
There are many positions that there are better people than us, and we are occupying it right now. Some women has married the best men, and they are enjoying it right now. Whereas some that are in the physical realm, more worldly, they don't have anything. All these are heavenly interventions. Right now, you are enjoying a miracle. Your life is a miracle. Better people, they are dead. Richer people. People sometimes that even do better things, they are no more. Can't you see now that your life should be all for His glory?
Yes.
Can't you see now that we should be ready to let go all things for Him and allow Him to give us all things? The man Jesus, God has used to deliver mankind. Even that was an earthly process. Let us go out as children of discernment. Trust that the Holy Ghost, what you do not know, ask the Holy Ghost to interpret it for you. Even when things are happening in your life, pray that the Holy Ghost will make you behold it as God has meant it to be. So that we don't go by error, go and thank our enemies. So that we don't go and thank devils and demons, who they themselves are the cause of our problems. There's only one thing that comes from God, and that is goodness. He's the Father of all good gifts and the giver of all goodness. Your miracles will come upon you in a manifold way. I declare it that it shall start raining upon you.
Yeah.
You are already in miracles, but more miracles shall shower upon you.
Yeah.
Just stand up and pray. Showers of miracles. Heavenly intervention. Heavenly intervention. From this very day, shall shower upon you. Shall shower upon me. Shall shower upon this land. Shall shower upon our family. We shall from today be hearing good news. Good news upon good news. We shall hear that it is well. We shall hear that it is well. We shall declare that it is well. Heavenly intervention shall be our portion. Earthly process God will use. But we will give Him all the glory. For in Him there is no evil. In Him is all goodness. Awesome God, we declare your glory. Awesome God, we come to thank you. Thank you for removing the scale away from our eyes. Thank you for removing the veil. Thank you for making us behold that it has all been you. It is you that have given strength. It is you that have given life. It is you that have given family. It is you that have given good health. It is you that fought and won battles. It is you that put bread on our table. It is you that makes us stand today. It is you that makes us get to that spiritual end. It is you that will take us in all the way to that place you have prepared for us. We shall fulfill our destiny in the name of Jesus.
And then you say, I've come to worship you.
we sleep, it is by your grace. It is heavenly intervention that has brought us this far. And it is also heavenly intervention that will get us to that expected end. Awesome God, you are in total control. You made all things to obey you. When we receive from the earth, it is you that has favored us. When we receive from our fellow men, it is you that has favored us. Unto you be all glory. Unto you be all thanksgiving. All worship. All obedience. Even now forevermore. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. The blessed sisters, I thank God for your life. Thank God for the church in Novara. I thank God for the victory that God has granted to you.
Amen.
And indeed to every one of us.
Amen.
Let us continue to abide in His presence.
Amen.
As we meet again on Wednesday,
yes,
7 p.m. in the evening, may the Lord cover every one of you,
amen,
with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.